content of the following program is not intended to be a substitute for professional medical advice, diagnosis, treatment, or cure. Always consult your physician or a health professional with any questions you may have regarding a medical condition. Go higher, baby. You're in the right place. You're listening to One Life Radio. This is Bernadette with Diamond Gray, Aviana Barrientos, Lexi Brinkley, and Kip Watson. It's girl team right now. Von Eaglin will be here in a little bit. So, yes. So what do you want to talk about, Kip Watson?
Oh.
Shrink.
Shoving it right back at me, are ya?
Yeah.
What's the vibe today?
We can't talk. We were going through Cosmo. Diamond, you were not in here, which I'm almost glad you weren't. You would not believe what we were talking about. Like, yeah. We were talking about very private stuff.
Well, now I'm curious.
No.
It's TMI.
Yeah,
it's
TMI.
TMI.
Yeah. Well, Lexi's very pregnant. I'll just say that.
And she's, yeah.
She's having trouble seeing things.
Yeah. I was just asking if she was able to still shave her legs because it's kind of hard to reach down a belly.
Oh, there's Von Eaglin.
Hello.
Yeah, I can't even tie my shoes anymore. So
yeah,
there's a lot of things that are made difficult.
I forgot about all that. It's been, it's been about 14 years since I was pregnant last. But
you
know what? I swear to God, between you and Maria, like, I'm nesting or something, because all my friends have been teasing me. Like, I have not stopped for weeks. Like, just cleaning out
house
stuff,
baking,
painting, just anything you can think of. So domestic. I even saved all my, of course, I've been doing this for a while. I save all my little jars from, like, my yogurt. Hey, Von, how you doing?
Hey, what's going on?
Von Eaglin. We got two shrinks in the house now.
Oh, yeah.
Kip Watson and Von Eaglin. But I've been, like, saving every little jar that I can, every little can, every
I
little
love jars.
Whatever. Yeah, and so I thought going to. I know this sounds
put
like
little flowers in them.
Yeah, I'm gonna plant little plants and just give them away and bring like a whole tray of little plants and just put them in the break room for everyone.
That's cute.
So, and that way they get recycled.
I like it.
Why are you making a face?
This is gonna be one of those things like cooking that you think, Kip, if you would just do this, you would be like fulfilled.
But I am right about the cooking.
Really?
Oh, you'd be fulfilled.
Yeah.
No.
You have to conquer your, I won't say fears. I don't think you have a fear
of
it.
It's not a fear.
Well,
I don't enjoy it.
Well, I'll be the shrink here. You know?
People have fear of
cooking. Maybe you do have a fear of cooking. Maybe you have a fear of failure.
No, not. I just don't enjoy it.
A fear of time lost.
That it's more of like, yeah, I'm wasting my time where I could be doing other things that I actually do and like doing.
Well, or that you do well. Maybe you don't want to do it because you don't do it well.
That is such BS. That is so. If you can read, you can cook. Like, there's no.
Oh, that's not true.
I don't know about that.
That is the mantra my mom told me. Yeah.
And no, I've ruined a lot of things, and I can read very well. I've ruined some serious dishes.
Is about timing. It's about making sure. It's like having a certain feel. You have to have an intuitive feel whenever
you
cook.
You have to be in the mood for sure to cook.
Yeah. I don't mind when
get
I
get some good music rolling.
It, but, like, yeah, I got to have short, simple.
Easy meals.
Easy.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just don't want to waste my time doing it.
And that's surprising because I know you're an athlete, so I would think that you do all this meal prep and you're.
I do.
Right.
Okay, I just don't.
She does it quickly.
I'm gonna be very complicated. I'm gonna be very female here.
Go for it.
Have you ever cooked a meal and cooked a really nice meal for a man?
Oh yeah.
Yes. Oh, all the time.
Okay. So
when I was with Donnie, I did it all the time.
Okay. So why would you take the time to do that for him and not yourself?
That's a good question.
You think you got me, but I do do that for myself.
Kip's in trouble. No.
Okay, hello. Like, I do that for myself.
Mm-hmm. I got her on the defensive.
No, because I'm like, I do that for myself.
You
think, like, I don't do it.
You said last week, not that I remember.
Not two hours.
You said 15 minutes is all you'll give.
I said 30 minutes.
Okay, 30 minutes. 30
minutes.
30 minutes. How long did you give your meals for Donnie?
Probably about 30, maybe 45 minutes.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
But you can do a really great meal in that amount of time.
I made a sheet pan last night. That's what.
A what?
Like I did like a sheet pan where you just do sweet potato.
Yeah.
Apples. I've never heard it called that. Is that like a country Texas?
No, you
it's
do
just,
it on
you
a,
do it all. You chop it all up. You put the chicken on top and then you bake it.
You call it a sheet pan?
It's a sheet pan meal.
Sheet pan. Just,
you do it all. It all goes at once.
I've never
like
heard
a sheet
that.
Cake.
But it was really, really, really good.
So. Yeah, I do that a lot.
And it's
took me
simple.
5 seconds
Very
to chop
simple.
Everything up.
And yet
and then
so
it
good.
Yep.
Well, I knocked out some quiche last night and the night before. It's so easy to make quiche. It is. If you
really?
Keep
I've yes. never made it before.
Really? So, I can't even tell you how easy it is.
It is easy.
So easy. See, even Kip says it's easy. So,
I've done them before. Yeah.
Okay. But it does take more than 15 to 30. Well, it doesn't
if
well,
you
chop
do
it all
the
up.
Crust by hand, of course.
Yeah.
Unless you buy the prepackaged
yeah.
ones,
Pillsbury
which
Joe
aren't
Boy.
Good. Yeah. Right. But they're not good for you.
Well, you can get some organic non-GMO, you know,
really?
Some good ones.
Okay. Okay.
Immaculate makes one that's at least doesn't have all the cheap oils. Don't ever buy like a Pillsbury one. That's like the worst junk on
but
the planet.
Yeah.
The cheapest oil, the cheap, it's just like, they're so full of preservatives
cheap,
and everything.
Cheap.
Yeah, they are. They're terrible, but it doesn't take that long. And you can actually make a crustless quiche.
A crustless quiche.
That's a hard word to say. Crustless quiche.
You have to say it fast
right?
three times.
I know. Can you say it three times fast?
Crustless quiche.
That's good. Good try. Good
yeah,
try.
But you just take four eggs, pasture raised, so they're not tortured, and then a cup of cream, which is one of the little tiny containers. It's a cup. It's 8 ounces.
Like milk cream?
Yeah, like heavy cream.
Okay.
Like
right.
heavy cream. You can use coconut cream, too, but then it gives it like a completely different texture.
Okay.
And I rarely use heavy cream anymore, but when I do, I use it in my quiche. And then, like, I had some leftover broccoli, so I chopped it up real small and a red onion in my chopped. It had that in my fridge and chopped that all up. And then some I always have Parmesan Reggiano, always, in my
Of course.
My kitchen.
Of course.
Well, no, you do.
The Parmesan Reggiano.
Well, and it's yes, and it's got all the good bacteria in it, so if you're going to eat cheese on occasion.
How about mozzarella? Is that acceptable?
I mean, I'm Italian. I love mozzarella, but you know, who does? The whole world loves mozzarella. Well,
I have a very cheesy Italian accent.
Yeah, it's
sorry.
Pretty bad.
It is.
It's okay. Hey.
We'll work on that.
Are you making fun of me?
Not at all.
Should I get all offended hire someone to, like, sue you?
I do diversity.
Yes. Let's get offended today with every little thing that we say.
Well, you know what? So you're the perfect person to ask this as an African-American man. Okay. So they were talking about Megyn Kelly.
Yeah.
Making some comments
it
about
would be interesting.
About being or for Halloween being a blackface or something like that.
She was saying that during while she was growing up, it was okay for kids to dress up and wear or paint their face with a darker shade,
yeah.
as long as it was for a costume or character.
Yeah, so
that is a very layered question. So, but
it's a very what question?
It's a layered answer simply because, you know, back in the day, like, that stuff was acceptable. It depends where you grow up, too. You know, like, if you grow up in an environment where there's not a lot of diversity and people do that and no one's going to call you out on that, then that may be acceptable. But
what if you're going as a zombie? I was a zombie once.
Well, you know, there's a lot of social context whenever you talk about being a blackface because black is typically associated with things that are negative. I mean, you just think about it. Okay, this is kind of going a little bit conspiracy theorist. But,
no, go ahead.
Okay. In pool, who dominates the table? The white ball. When the black ball sinks, you win the game. Who goes first in chess?
I'm guessing.
The white piece. The
well,
white
I've never
piece.
Played
the
chess.
Dark piece goes second. Okay. What color is Angel's food cake?
White.
What color is Devil's food cake?
Chocolate, dark.
Right.
Okay.
What happens when a black cat crosses your path?
Bad luck.
Exactly. So you see what I'm saying? All these things that are associated with black.
I never thought about any of that.
A lot of stuff is negative anytime you talk about black. And when you go back all the way into slavery and stuff, I mean, it's like there's something that is ingrained that is in our subconscious that whenever you think of things being darker, a lot of times you associate things that are negative. You know, if you look at a criminal activity, it's usually somebody who's darker skin or whatever the case is. Like your mind naturally goes in that direction. And so
the
I don't
pool
think.
Pool game. Pool. You know, I never thought about that.
I mean,
but
you think about it.
Well,
you know,
isn't it because, though, I guess the white ball stands out and all the other ones are dark or rich in color?
I mean, you can say what you want. I'm just saying, like, those are just some associations that a lot of times, like, okay, at a wedding, what color do you wear?
White.
What about a funeral?
Unless you're a whore. No.
Yeah.
I'm joking.
Well, that's not true. She doesn't deserve in the Indian culture.
You're right. That's in an Indian culture. Different, that's in an Indian culture. You're right. Yeah. In different cultures, it is different. But
I think
a lot
it's
of
like
times,
red. They wear red.
Yeah, and I want to clarify. Saying, there's a lot of whores that have worn white. Okay,
yeah, I'm sure. But that kind of goes back to, I think, to a scriptural culture of being thought of as pure and white.
No, you're right about that. Well, I'm just saying, like growing up as an African American male, a lot of times, we have interracial discrimination because the darker your skin, and it's not just in Black culture, Hispanic culture, and Indian culture, the darker your skin color, if you're the closer you are to being white, the more acceptable you are. And so, why do you think Black women get perms? Because it's easier to accept. People are naturally comfortable with things that they know, and so it's tribalism is really what it boils down to. Is that it's us against them?
This is interesting though because some of the athletes that I've worked with, the lighter skinned blacks that I've worked with, said they've been ridiculed as not being Black enough.
Right, that's true.
Interracial discrimination.
Yeah, what's up with that?
I was like, what? What are you talking about?
I'm lighter skinned African American.
Yeah,
and so,
and you're Beyonce's cousin.
I appreciate Yes, I am. So,
did you know that, Diamond? Beyonce's like his second cousin?
No, it's not second. It's distant, but you know. So,
well,
but
she was at your family reunion. That's pretty close.
Destiny's Child did dance at our family reunion.
That's awesome.
In Anahuac, Texas, growing up. So Beyonce, you know, shout out to you, kinfolk. But yeah, the lighter your skin color, and Diamond, feel free to chime in on this. A lot of times you're looked at as being, you know, highly favored. And so, because like with my friend, if he's darker skin, sometimes we'll joke around and say, hey, you know, he'll call me a house Negro and I'll call him a field Negro. And it's a joke.
Oh my God.
It's serious. I'm being totally serious with you, you know, because, you know, he's darker skin. So he was working out in the field. I was lighter skin. I was probably the master's, you know, offspring or so on and so forth.
I'm sure.
A lot of times there is interracial discrimination.
Maybe you're related. What's the president that loved Black women? Andrew Jackson?
A lot of them did.
Who was
Jefferson
it?
Did. I know
or Jefferson.
Some,
that's
Jefferson
who I'm thinking of.
Kids.
Jefferson. Yeah. Thomas Jefferson. He had some women.
Yeah,
now.
He did. He did.
Jeez.
I should have been. Well, so... I guess just to go along with that, so the lighter skin, like when I was growing up, a lot of times I wasn't Black enough. They called me Cracker and Peckerwood growing up. The Black kids did.
And what? Pecker?
Peckerwood.
Peckerwood?
This is an old country term.
I thought Pecker was something else. I thought that was a penis.
Anyway, that's what they called me. That's all I know. And so... but a lot of times they will call me that, and you're not Black enough, or you don't identify with us. A lot of times if a Black person speaks proper English, they're made fun of, or they're called an Oreo. You know, like you're
really?
Black on the outside but white on the inside.
Wow. Okay, so Diamond, you're African American woman. What do you want to say about all this?
Yeah, no, there's definitely something with the Oreo term of the way I talk, you know, if you grew up in a certain area, you know, regular King's English is considered to be like speaking white when that's actually just, and that's a problem with both sides of putting that together. As far as the blackface conversation, I just think that if everyone just takes some time to learn their history about like Amos and Andy and all of the people that would put on blackface to make fun, when you open that door back open for everyone to do that again, it opens the door for that same kind of like costuming.
Well, I agree.
Ridicule
Well, and it is scary. I mean, look at what happened in North Carolina just a few months ago. You know what I'm talking? Or is it South Carolina? You know where they had tiki torches and everything.
Tiki torches.
When Donald Trump. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah.
What was that? What was that controversy? Do you guys remember?
So you had white supremacists coming together, to celebrate, you know, pretty much white supremacy. And so Dave Chappelle calls them the tiki torch whites or whatever. But there was a lot of discrimination and a lot of tension in the area simply because you had one side who was, saying white power pretty much, and the other side saying, like, this is not appropriate, this is not right. And so a lot of violence broke out because of that. And so,
it's kind of crazy. It is, but so I guess, I'm glad we talked about
we got
it.
Deep real
I was
quick.
Thinking, well, you
I know, we did.
I'm thinking if you went, you know, so many costumes, like, we were thinking about going as, you know, vegetables and fruits and stuff like that. I don't know. I think
Kip said she was Michael Jackson.
I went Michael Jackson in college one time.
The light-skinned Michael Jackson or the dark one?
Well, you know, I made my face brown and my hands brown, right?
Yeah,
you know?
But you were MJ. You weren't doing anything.
I did the costume. I had the sparkly glove.
I think Michael Jackson a little different than blackface, though, because blackface has a different social connotation to it.
Yeah.
So.
Well, this is 86, 87.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So I don't know if that would be
different
today
or not. I need to Google blackface
because
I kind of know what we're talking about, but maybe I don't know the history like Diamond says, so I'm going to get myself up to speed. So we've got a great show coming up. Kip Watson's going to be talking about why the self-help movement is creating more unhappiness happiness. And Von Eaglin is going to be talking about beneath the surface, underlying problems in relationships, communication. That's a big one. And we'll be right back. You're listening to One Life Radio.